Okay, this is a demo video for network remote for TiVo version 0.31 running on OS X Yosemite. This window here is not part of the app, this is just to show the output of the TiVo. So we start up the app, and it looks for TiVos on the LAN automatically. And if it finds any, we get a nice little list here in button form. And if it doesn't find any, or the one you want's not in the list, you can enter the address here. In this case, we're going to use Juliet, the Romeo. Now, this has most of the buttons. I mean, it's all the buttons that are on the TiVo Peanut, and a few extras. So let's start up the TiVo. And you see we can navigate by pressing on the buttons, clicking on the buttons like this, but we can also use keyboard shortcuts, which is how I would normally work. And most of the keyboards, some of the keyboard shortcuts are obvious, some of them you just have to learn. Alright, one thing you can do with this that you can't do with the Peanut is toggle closed captions on directly without pulling up the menu. Let's see. Another interesting feature is text entry. You can click on the text box here. Just type with the keyboard. Let's see, it appears there. Now that will work on most places where there's text entry on the TiVo menus. However, a few places, and this is the way this was originally implemented, this feature, before TiVo added direct text entry to the API, you have to navigate the Ouija board, as we call it. In this case, there are five columns. This is the column selector here. Zero does direct text entry. But if I set it to five, you can watch it navigate the Ouija board. All right. Now this app's window here is a bit tall and thin. It doesn't fit on every screen. If it happens not to fit on your screen, you can switch to landscape mode with capital L. Switch back again. And if you don't like these pseudo-graphical buttons here made of Unicode characters, you can toggle those on and off with capital G. Now, one thing I should show you is before you can use any network remote function, you have to enable it here. This is turned off by default. All right, now. We have a direct standby button, which is not on any TiVo remote. Shuts the whole thing down immediately. And that's about it.